आओ ट्विस्ट करे टना ट्विस्ट करे, आओ ट्विस्ट करे
हे व्हाट आर
ओ
यू डूइंग वर्गो, व्हाट आर यू डूइंग,
ट्विस्ट
व्हाट
करे
इज रॉन्ग विद यू?
ट्विस्ट
व्हाई व्हाई व्हाई
ना
डू यू वांट टू ट्विस्ट?
सी वी हैव कम टुगेदर फॉर अ स्पेशल पर्पस राइट.
करेक्ट
वी आर डूइंग अ न्यू सेगमेंट इन आवर
करेक्ट
चैनल एंड आई
करेक्ट
वाज थिंकिंग अबाउट द नेम ऑफ दिस सेगमेंट एंड फॉर द
करेक्ट
पास्ट फ्यू डेज दिस सॉन्ग आओ ट्विस्ट करे दिस सॉन्ग हैज बीन प्लेइंग ऑन माय माइंड. सो हाउ अबाउट नेमिंग दिस सेगमेंट आओ डिस्कस करे. Because see, we will be discussing anything and everything about any sport, not only cricket, any sport, good, bad, controversial. We will be discussing with our guests, we'll be discussing with our subscribers, our followers. So I thought of keeping this name. What do you think?
What do I think? I think oh, discuss करे, oh, discuss करे.
Okay. So the topic for the first episode of this new segment is that Sanju Samson. Sanju Samson is the topic because the game between Rajasthan Royals and Punjab Kings was a high scoring affair. Samson scored a century, he was the hero. But there was a talking point in the last over of the game when 13 runs were needed. Arshdeep Singh was defending. He was bowling the last over. The first ball Sanju Samson faced, it was a dot ball. Second ball was a single. Third ball, Morris also ran a single. Fourth ball, Sanju Samson hit for a six. So two balls, five runs were required. Sanju Samson then played a cover drive, which went straight to the sweeper cover, Huda. And Sanju Samson got out a few steps. Decided to run at first, but then didn't run. Morris went to the striker's end and almost ran back. So he almost ran two runs. Sanju Samson refused the run. It was still one ball, five runs were left. Last ball of the inning, Sanju Samson tried to hit a six or a boundary and he got out in the same region, in the cover region. So here, Krisha, I want to ask you, what would Sanju Samson would have done better? In the hindsight, it's easy to say a lot of things, but what could he have done? Was he right in refusing the single and taking the onus on himself to hit a boundary at the last ball? Because he was going great guns, he was timing the ball really well.
Well, I think as you said, there are like two, three answers to this. In the hindsight, it's easier, obviously. But my only point here is, I think that was there. When he actually denied the single, that is the point that I mentioned to my father as well. That see, if he ran that single, four runs would have been needed of the last ball, right? Now, if four runs were needed of the last ball and Chris Morris was facing, Chris Morris is capable of hitting boundaries as well as sixes. So there's no question there. But in case of boundaries, see, a boundary is easier because an edge can go to a boundary. I know there are people who will say, okay, an edge can go for six as well. But then you have to hit the ball, really hard for it to go for a six. The elevation should be there. So for six, a number of things have to be correct. But for a boundary, a badly timed ball, a misfielding, because remember, Punjab was also under a lot of pressure because Punjab was losing a game that they should have won. And given the fact that Punjab's fielding wasn't the best yesterday. So the problem, I mean, I wouldn't say a problem. On the hindsight, I feel Sanju Samson will blame himself for that, not taking that single. Because four runs of one ball, you never know. A Yorker, Rahul misses, or it just goes behind somewhere, four runs, and Rajasthan could have won. But for six, because it becomes five for one ball, and you don't have any other option but to hit a six. So that again becomes a little tough. What do you think? What was your call?
I have a different kind of view to this one. So the ball, the fifth ball, which he timed really well, it went straight to the fielder. So, and Morris took a head start because he was at the non-striker's end. He was already halfway down the track by the time he did. What didn't work out in favor of Sanju Samson was that he could have run two also. If the throw was at his end, but it was a wild throw. Because the fielder was also under pressure, it was way off target. He could have run two also, but because it went straight to the fielder, I think he thought that he won't be able to complete the second run and a new batsman would come in place if he gets run out. So that was another option. If you'd ran two, either he would have completed the run or gotten run out. Or another thing could have happened. If the throw would have been at the non-striker, then Morris could have also got out. Or maybe he could have also completed the single. These are all ifs and buts, but I felt that Sanju, after taking that first step, he felt that it had already reached the fielder and it would be a big risk for him to come for the second run. And I think from the first outset only, he thought that he will face the last two balls. Because he was timing the ball so well, I felt that, and if the Mumbai ground, as you know, is very small. But he felt that anything, if it's in his arc, and if you see, Ashdeep was bowling the same line outside of stump. So he somehow got an idea that the ball will be outside of stump. He predicted that because all five balls were outside of stump. What he thought that I will go, and he had hit a six over cover. What he thought that even if it's five runs or six runs or whatever it is at the last ball, he would be able to clear the fence. What happened, like we were discussing it yesterday, because it was the last ball, he went for power instead of timing. And that's how he sliced the ball. And the ball before, like the fourth ball, which he hit for six, was full time, was total timing. So that is something which didn't fall in place for him.
Because see, Orgo, he was under pressure. And he was under pressure because it was five runs of the last ball. So automatically, what eventually happens is when you are under pressure and you are thinking all that I got to do is hit a six. So you will go full power. Because that's how you associate a six with, you know. Generally, the reason why people say someone like a Dravid or a Mithali cannot hit six. If you see, in recent times, Mithali has been hitting sixes. It hasn't been raw power. It hasn't been a brute force like a Hardik Pandya. It has been sheer timing, right? In the same way, Samson is about timing. He's more of a timing player. But because that target was in his mind that I have to hit a six. But here I have a point. Orko, do you think Sanju could have considered, I know this is going to be a very unpopular opinion or whatever, but I was just thinking, if you were Sanju, would you consider hitting a boundary instead and taking it to the super over?
Given the ground dimension, I would have also gone for a six because if it's in the arc, even if it's missed time, you saw a lot of balls in this match, in the Delhi Capitals versus Chennai match, a lot of balls just about cleared the fence, which was in the arc and not well timed. So what he thought that let's finish the match, let's not go for a boundary, because if he had went for a boundary, like a four, and for example, if he couldn't, if it met the fielder, that would have resulted in maximum three runs, not more than that. Then also they could have lost the game. So that was the problem. And I think he backed himself, just that the execution was not there. All other shots which he hit in that match perfectly were timed. This one, the execution was not there. I was thinking about Dinesh Karthik and the Nidahas Trophy when he executed.
You please don't think about Dinesh Karthik. Please. Viewers and me.
Overcovered, he went for timing. Then also, I think it was five or four of the last ball. He went for timing, it went for six.
Correct.
That was one point, but credit to Sanju that he backed himself. Another thing, because Morris was new, he had just come in the 19th over, I guess. So, he was not timing the ball also. I felt if it would have been that guy, if it would have been Yann Parakh, I think he would have run that simple. Because
Parag
had already hit 3-4-6.
See, the problem with Chris Morris is also that he hasn't played anything before this also, right?
Yeah.
So when he comes here, he needs match practice. He can hit boundaries and sixes, agree. And that's why I was telling you that in case of a boundary, see, you don't need a well-timed four. Nobody cares. If it's a run, it's a run. You know what I'm saying? So if it's a mistimed four also, because last ball, he would have gone for a big hit. Yeah, he could have also got out, but you never know, you know, somewhere it edged and a boundary. I always feel, and I think everybody will agree, a boundary is easier to hit than a six, right? So, no, absolutely no offense to Sanju for trying it, for backing himself up. And why not? Orko, the kind of innings he was playing, he should back himself. I mean, he was brilliant, right? So, should we tell our viewers that we are going to come up with pressing issues around the world of sports often?
Definitely. And if the viewers, that is, if you all have any opinion regarding this case, whether it should have been a single, whether it should, he did right or whatever you feel, just put it in the comment section. Also, the viewers should give us ideas about topics which we should discuss, interesting topics. And also write to us on Facebook, on Instagram, on YouTube, so that we can get your comments and know about your opinion too. And also, please subscribe the channel, share the videos, like us on Facebook, and follow us on Instagram. And we will be bringing more exciting content.
Absolutely. So, until the next time, quickly subscribe, ring the notification icon, and please, please, please keep watching and keep supporting.